Hey guys, this is Miles from Swiss Crypto Podcast, and in this video, I'm going to talk about inflation and its potential effects on the cryptocurrency space. So stay tuned and let's get into it. Before we start, as always, the quick disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor, and whatever I say should not be taken as any legal tax or financial advice. Please always do your own research before you invest into anything. To start things off, in this video, I want to give you a quick definition of what inflation really is. Inflation is when the prices of goods in a country are going up and up, and more money is needed to pay for those goods. So basically, your earned money is now worth less, or is losing worth day by day or month by month. So how could this be possibly a good thing for the cryptocurrency space, you ask? And I want to show you exactly why this could be a great thing actually for the cryptocurrency space with the example of Venezuela. As you guys probably heard from the news, there is a lot of inflation going on in Venezuela and they are fighting very high inflation rates. So Venezuela currently has an inflation rate of, listen up to this, 488,000%. And this inflation rate is expected to be at 1,000,000% by the end of the year 2018. To show you guys what this means, with a practical example, the prices in Venezuela are doubling every 26 days. So a cup of coffee is now actually costing 2.5 million bolivars. And in 26 days, it will most probably be 5 million bolivars for only one cup of coffee. So their money is losing worth day by day, month by month. So how could these people probably profit from the cryptocurrency space, you ask? There are about 32 million people in Venezuela with a monthly income of $15 to $30 per month. So if those people would search for another option to invest their money in, and this would be the cryptocurrency space, as they are searching for a stable currency, as for example Tether as a stable coin, or even Bitcoin as a store of value that probably will gain in price in the next few years, they could make some real profit out of their initial investment, and they can be sure that their money that they are now earning will be worth the same or even more in the future. So if every person in Venezuela, 32 million people, would invest $5 per person each month in crypto, doesn't matter which coin, it must be quite a stable one so they can be sure that their money is safe. But if they would invest $5 each month, that would mean that 160 million US dollars are flowing into the cryptocurrency space each month. And we could apply the same example to Argentina. Argentina is now fighting an inflation rate of 40%, which is also quite high, not as high as 488,000%, but 40% is already very high. Argentina has a population of 44 million people and they have a monthly income of about $500 US. So if every person in Argentina would invest $100 US into the cryptocurrency space each month, that would mean that $4.4 billion would flow into the cryptocurrency space each month. Now remember, the current market cap of the cryptocurrency space is at about $210 billion. So if people from Argentina and Venezuela realize that they could put their money into the cryptocurrency space to save their money from inflation, that would mean that there would be about $4 to $5 billion per month flowing into the cryptocurrency space. And I know this is only potential thinking, of course. This is only an example. Not every person in Argentina will put $100 US into crypto each month. But as crypto gets more adopted each year and each month, the news will be spread that there is another investment option that could save them from inflation and that could save their wealth from inflation. And I believe this could play a very, very important role, especially in countries with high inflation rates as Venezuela, as Argentina, but also Turkey with 25% of inflation rate, or South Africa with 5.4% of inflation rate. So always think about possibilities like this, that we can see more adoption in the cryptocurrency space, that we could see more money that will flow into the cryptocurrency space that we haven't even thought of could flow into the cryptocurrency space. I mean, inflation is a very bad thing for the people that are experiencing it in Venezuela or Argentina, but it could mean a good thing to the cryptocurrency space because it will hire the market cap, because there will be more money flowing into the cryptocurrency space. And in the end, also, there will be flowing more trust into those cryptocurrencies when people realize that there are a lot more safe ways to store their wealth in cryptocurrency as there are in the economy that we have right now with banks. So I hope I could give you an interesting overview over why inflation doesn't necessarily mean a bad thing right now, and that inflation could bring a lot of positive things to the cryptocurrency space. If you liked it, like the video, subscribe, and see you in the next one.